pump adrenaline. I'm in the middle of a plane crash and it's way past all exiting. The feeling in the pit of my stomach's unsettling. Each second passing by it seems like it never ends. The roar of the engines and the screams of fear is all I hear. Then crack, then black, then clear, silence. I'm aware I've died and my soul is rising. I find it calming yet alarming all at the same time. I still don't know what's going on, my physical presence is at home, but spiritually I'm in the same mind. I see that same light, all near-death experiences talk about, but I don't hear any voice talking loud. I'm grown, but I feel like I can walk around till I realize that I'm existing within the particles of light that have been making me rise this whole time. I'm measuring the source, the one, the essence, the sun, the energy from which brings light through. The sun becomes my mind's eye, which I see right through. I strum the string theory of time, galactic equations become my glue. I am one with you, you are one with all. The beginning begins with the end of it all. It's sad that you have to pass and move on before accepting you were God all along. When life evolved, fighting for survival in existence, I reverberate through the melodies and lyrics I've written.
You can run, you can cry, but you just can't hide. No matter what you try, we all born to die. So take it and face it, cause when it's said and did, life ain't promised, but death is destined. You can run, you can cry, but you just can't hide. No matter what you try, we all born to die. So take it and face it, cause when it's said and did, life ain't promised, but death is destined.
Soar through the galaxies and explore them. Do the spirits congregate in a post-mortem ghost forum? Or do they sit among the angels and oracles and cordially compare stories on how they cross through the mortal to immortal portals? See, some believe your essence interspaced in. It's reissued and placed in another vessel. This is reincarnation. While some see an ethereal destination, others state that moral deviation downgrades you to one of Satan's patrons. Once you enter that eternal calming, your final evening, night and morning, all internal organs are gone from the embalming. Whether ascending or plummeting, your last breath is all that life is promising. Seances conducted for spirit summoning. When you stand over the coffin with a clear view and speak into the ear of the dead man near you, do you feel that he can hear you? Or are you just speaking to a shell? Most of us dwell within the realm of speculation, merely peeking through the veil.
You can run, you can cry, but you just can't hide. No matter what you try, we all born to die. So take it and face it, cause when it's said and did, life ain't promised, but death is destined. Run, you can cry, but you just can't hide. No matter what you try, we all born to die. So take it and face it, cause when it's said and did, life ain't promised, but death is destined.
In a blazing haven, the patrons forsaken and shaken for making and breaking their deals with Satan. They got me in Hell's Lobby with Whitney and Bobby, John Gotti, Kaylee Anthony's mommy. And she got the baby body. I ponder and wander misdeeds and proceed to believe it's a blunder. My brain is insane, I maintain this disease that I'm under. I'm shown the sins I committed, the women I cheated. The devil admitted that not many could beat it, conceded. His influence, a pursuance for money and power, devour the soul. It's so out of control, how do I get out of this hole? I'm stuck here for eternity, 10,000 bits are burning me. My soul was not devout, the plague is in my mouth. A legion of demons are screaming, tell me I'm dreaming. A heathen seeking for reasons, I'm bleeding tears out my eyes. It is clear as to why I was placed in Hades' tomb. For the years I will fry for being wicked out the womb.
You can run, you can cry, but you just can't hide. No matter what you try, we all born to die. So take it and face it, cause when it's said and did, life ain't promised, but death is destined. Run, you can cry, but you just can't hide. No matter what you try, we all born to die. So take it and face it, cause when it's said and did, life ain't promised, but death is destined.
Put down your Bible, Quran, and Torah, and let's have a little discussion. How would you live your life if you knew there was no repercussions? If I took the ultimate round trip ticket of my body, were to release me, if I came back a week later and told you what happened, would you believe me? If heaven and hell didn't exist, and human life is just an experiment, and there's no invisible policeman using scare tactics for you to repent, would you do things differently? Would your conscience be as loud? Would you be doing more of the fucked up shit that you're doing right now? Research shows the human body carries a fixed amount of energy. Energy that can't be created nor destroyed is written in theories. Human consciousness of the human soul, as far as I can tell, if that consciousness disappear simply because the devil myself, maybe some human souls are strong enough to exist outside the body. And maybe that explains what you saw the other night in that hotel lobby. The human eyes
can only see so much. Something like fish that can't look up. The light of the tunnel could be a birth canal in another dimension.
You can run, you can cry, but you just can't hide. No matter what you try, we all born to die. So take it and face it, cause when it's said and did, life ain't promised, but death is destined. Run, you can cry, but you just can't hide. No matter what you try, we all born to die. So take it and face it, cause when it's said and did, life ain't promised, but death is destined.